So now it's time for you to meet Carol. And as I mentioned at the beginning of this course, Carol is working in finance. And her job is to design algorithms that will optimize financial investments. So given recent market turmoils, her employer has asked her to come up with an algorithm that will help them design a secure portfolio of investments. So the problem that Carol is looking at is actually quite similar to the one that Bob is looking at. She is looking at a number of investment opportunities for a company. For example, she could invest in precious metals such as gold, silver, or maybe even copper. She could also invest in stocks, so for example, a copper mining company, or in a silver and copper mining company, or she could invest in an industrial manufacturer, or also in some other bank. So in order for the portfolio to be secure, she wants to spread her risk as much as possible. So she doesn't want to invest in things that are too similar or too closely connected. So for example, she wants to invest either in gold or in silver. But this line here basically tells us that she doesn't want to invest in both at the same time. And so she basically only wants to invest in one of those precious metal. If she invests in copper, she probably does not want to invest in the mining company, because then if the copper price goes down, so will the stock of the copper mining company. Similar here, this is a silver and copper mining, so you either invest in this company or in those precious metals here. If the industrial manufacturer is actually a supplier to this company here, you probably wouldn't want to invest in both of them at the same time. And let's say that the bank down here is backing the two mining companies. So you either invest in the bank, or maybe also these two mining companies separately, but you definitely would not want to, well, actually, let's just say you also didn't want to invest in two mining companies at the same time. So in order to spread the risk as much as possible, Carol, of course, wants to find a portfolio that contains as many different items as possible, because then she has spread out her risk. But at the same time, she must observe those rules. So she cannot just select all of these possibilities, but only possibilities that are not connected to each other. So in a way, that is very similar to Bob's problem, because Bob, when he was looking at the genes, he was looking for genes where every gene is connected to every other gene. And now Carol is looking for possible investments that are not connected at all to each other. So what is the largest portfolio, or how many items can Carol select at maximum so that none of them are connected? I would like you to figure that out as our next quiz. And I would like you to put your answer here in this box, please.